Sorry, just making a second breakfast. Got me a toasty, a warm cookie and a coffee. You know what? That's quite a lot of energy I just used up there. These had to be baked, the milk had to be pasteurized, all the ingredients were grown, harvested, packaged, transported, refrigerated, cooked. Oh wow, that's a lot of energy just to make me a snack. I feel so privileged. Hi, my name is David, and welcome to Questacon's digital science show, Your Energy. This series of videos has been put together by Questacon to get people talking about energy, about how energy is sourced, stored and used now and into the future. And you'll be involved because it's your energy. Have you ever thought about how much energy you use every day, sometimes without even thinking about it? How many items do you have in your house that use energy? Not just electrical objects, but devices that use other fuels. Your log fire, your lawnmower for cutting the grass, your gas for cooking, heating and barbecuing. What about you? What energy do you consume? That would be food. We all need energy for our lives. One of the Sustainable Development Goals is SDG 7, affordable and clean energy for all. That's a basic human need. Can you have an energy-free day? If you stayed at home, didn't cook, didn't watch anything, nope. Just being alive consumes energy. In fact, even if you are dead, then microbes will consume your energy. You can't stop the transfer. But before we go any further, we need to define energy. And we use energy to do work. Well, work is just about anything. Running, walking, lifting, breathing, sleeping. And if we turn that around, any work we do consumes energy. Energy may exist in potential, kinetic, thermal, electrical, chemical, nuclear, or other forms. We cannot create or destroy energy, only transform it. For example, plants. The sun's energy provides the plant light and heat energy. That energy is transformed into chemical energy inside living tissue. We then eat the tissue. In our body, this energy is transformed into heat, other living tissues, and the ability to do physical work. Sometimes we inefficiently use energy. An old incandescent light bulb, for example, was not very efficient. Have you ever noticed an old light bulb getting hot? When transforming electrical energy into light energy, a lot is transformed into heat energy instead. Now, this digital show is not so much about the energy inside us, more about the industrial energy that we consume as a society. A society that is totally dependent upon its energy. As such, we called this show Your Energy. You have access to many differently sourced energies, and as such, you have the choices about where that energy comes from. And that is a very important question. Do you care where your energy comes from? In fact, I'd like you to write down your answer and hang on to it. We might look at that later on.